Hello everyone. First of all, thank you so much for supporting my work. And today's tutorial we'll learn step by step seismic analysis of three-story building in ETABS and verify result by manually analysis of example. Let's start. This is the example you can see on the screen. This is the example of SK Duggal earthquake resisting design of structure. In this example, you can see here a plan of 4 meters span each and total is 8 by 8 meters building size and 3 story of each story 3.5 meter. In this problem, the RCC school building and the building have located in zone 5. Okay, the soil is medium and the design building with special moment resisting frame, it means R value is 5. Response reduction factor for special movement resisting frame is 5. Intensity of dead load is this and the live load is this, and determine the design seismic load of the structure by static analysis. Okay, now what we do, first of all I'm going to the ETAB, go to the new model and this window is appear, select the third option and select my unit is metric India, steel design for IS 800 and concrete design for 456. After select this parameter, click on OK. Okay, this window is appeared. Now what we do? Okay, one more thing I want to tell you. You can download this ETAB file as well as handwritten notes from the description. Okay, first of all we have to define grid for making a structure. Go to the problem, you can see here this is x-axis in plan. In x-axis the spacing is 4 meter but the line on this axis, vertical line, is 3. It means number of line in x direction is 3, and same as this is y-axis and number of line in y-axis is 1, 2, and 3, and the spacing is same as 4 meter. Okay, you know that the Z axis is vertical axis in ETAB. You can change, but default is Z. Okay, go to the ETAB. Okay, number of grid line in X direction is 3, in Y direction is 3, and spacing is 4 meter and 4 meter. Change here data, 3, 3, 4, 4. Okay, because the spacing of this span is uniform, that's why we don't need to choose this option. Okay, now number of story is 3 and the all story height is 3.5, bottom and typical. Typical means above the bottom, so you can change here 3 and 3.5 meter of story height and then click on OK. Okay, this is the plan window, this is the 3D window, and this is the model explorer, and you can add more than 2 view, but 2 view is enough. And this line is the grid that I'm defined, 4 meter, and this is 1 floor, 2 floor, 3 motor, look like our example. This is grid, not beam column. The next step is to define material. Okay, in this problem you can see the manually analysis of the whole problem, and lastly analysis the lateral load at each floor is this, and we verify this result by ETAB. Okay, so in this problem self weight is not considered. If self weight is not considered, it means you don't have to choose a specific material. You can choose any material, any grade of concrete, because self weight is not considered. So what we do, go to the ETAB and go to define button and define material. Without material is not analysis, that's why we have to choose a material. So go to the add new, India concrete and M25 is default. I am selecting M25 Indian concrete and OK. This is the properties of M25 concrete. If you want to learn ETABS every detail you can comment. Okay, this is M25 because self-void is not considered, so that's why we not any touching this property, only okay, and you can see the listed of M25 concrete in ETAB. Okay, now the second thing in this problem, first is defined material, self-weight is not considered, that's why we choose M25, and self-weight is not considered, that's mean the cross-section size of the beam and column is not given in this problem. The result is verify only depend upon the dead or live loads. Okay, so we choose any cross-section of the beam and column. So go to the define section properties, frame section, in ETABs, frames we can say beam and column, and cells we can say slab. Okay, go to the frame, add new property, rectangular. We choose rectangular column, title is column, and material is M25, and the size is 350 by 350 a square column. Okay, so what we do, we title column, material M25, size is 350 by 350 and okay. You can see in the list column. Now add a new property, again rectangular, and select the title is beam, M25 material, and the size of the beam is 300 is depth and 230 is width, and okay. Now you can see the beam is also appear in the list. Okay, first step is define grid, second step define material, third step is define properties, cross section. Now we can start to draw. So what we do, if you draw one beam here, automatically draw here and here and here. If you choose here all story, if you choose default one story, so if you draw here a beam, only one beam is draw. So what we do, we choose all story and go to the beam. This is the beam, red dot. When you click on this beam, beam drawer tool, when you click, this properties appear, and in this property you can change property beam, that's you define already beam. After select beam and all story, drag over the plan, and you can see automatically all beams draw. You can see in the 3D view. As same as you can go to the column. This is the column making tool, and this is the property. Change here column and then drag. Property, column, and drag. Automatically all column create. Okay, the second step is third step is done. Now the support on this problem at the base is fixed. So we have to provide support at fix. Goes first of all, if you don't know the ETAB basics, so you listen this carefully. This is the plan and this is the top view. If you select this beam, if I am selecting this beam, you can see in 3D the all beam are selected, because here is all story selected. If one select one story I am select, then select one beam, after unselect you can check only top beam is select. It means this is the top view, because when I click on beam, the top view is click. Okay, if you go to the down arrow, this you go to the next floor. Okay, so I'm going second floor, first floor, and this is the base, and one story selected. Now drag and select the all base points where we assign support. Now go to the assign, joints, and restrain. Restrain means support. Click and select fix support and okay. And zoom out, zoom in 3D view, you can see here this is the fix support symbol. Now again go to the plan and select top view. This is the top view. Okay, now support is done. Now the very important thing, dead load intensity is 10 kilonewton per meter square. Per meter square is area load, and area load is applicable for only cells load, only slab load. But here is not slab. So what we do, we create a slab and change the property of slab is cell fate is zero. Then we apply this load. Only for applying this dead load, we create a slab with cell fate is zero. Okay. So now define a slab section and slab. Add new slab and slab 100 means slab 100 mm thickness, M25 and thickness is 100. Because we change the property cell fate is zero, the norm mean of this all these things. Okay. Okay. This is slab 100. Okay. Then if you want to draw slab on all floor, go to the here change all story. Select this is the slab. This is the slab button and change the slab property. Then drag from here to here. Okay. Slab 100 and click this point and to this point. And the all story automatically created slab. Now the base slab, this slab. This slab is not required. We have to delete this slab. So first of all, you go to one story. By down key, go to the base. And by normal cursor, click and delete the slab. Now go to the top view. Okay, this is the top view. Now we have to provide dead load. Select all story and click on one slab, all slab select. Go to the assign, cells load and uniform load. Okay, here you can see the unit is kilonewton per meter square. Dead load is given is 10 in dead load, 10 in gravity direction. Okay, okay, you can see here 10, 10, 10. Okay, now select again. First of all, change one story because live load is not apply on top terrace. Okay, we apply live load according to the problem on this and this. So what we do, go to the one story, select here and select manually two slabs by control button and assign cells load uniform, change live load here is 3 kilonewton per meter square and okay, live load is apply. You can see live load 3 but not here. Okay, dead load and live load we provided. Now is very important self weight is zero. So how to create self weight is zero? Select control A whole structure, go to the assign cells and stiffness modify, assign cells then stiffness modify. You can change here self weight of the slab is zero. Okay, assign cells stiffness and make here the value of two parameter is zero because self weight of the slab is not considered in the problem. We given the input according to the problem. Okay, now you can see here PM property modifier is applied. Now again select whole structure and go to the assign. Now we change the property of beam and column, frames, property modifier and zero, and zero same step and okay. Now load is done. Now what we do, go to the problem and next here given the design parameters, seismic zone 5 and the importance factor is 1.5. for general building is importance factor 1 and important building like school, hospital is 1.5. response reduction for special moment resting frame is 5. Okay, we have to apply this. So what we do, go to the define and go to the load pattern. This is the load pattern where we seismic definition apply. Define load pattern. Already two load we have, dead load, live load. If we type here seismic and select type is seismic and select here seismic code IS 1893-2002 is Indian code for seismic analysis. Select this code and add. You can see here one more load, add seismic, then click on modify. Okay, here we select only x direction, we verify the result only x direction. So uncheck all, and the 0.36 factor for zone 5, soil is medium, soil factor is 2, okay, good. Importance factor is 1.5 according to the problem, because this is school building. Response reduction is 5, and time period is also given in the problem. This is the time period you can calculate by this formula, 0.334 second. 0.334 seconds. Then okay and okay. One more very important thing in seismic analysis in E-tab. According to IS code, if the live load is less than or equal to 3 kN per meter square, then we use only 25% of live load. If more than 3 kN, we use 50% of live load. So how can apply this? So go to the define and mass source. Click here and modify the already default mass and change the title mass. And click here, checkbox, click here in all 6 parameters. Now what you do, dead load is 1, is mean full dead load we consider add, then change live load and here parameter is 0.25 and add. Why we do this? Because according to IS code, if live load is less than or equal to 3 kN per meter square, then we use only 25% of live load. Okay. Then okay, yes, okay. Now analysis, save this model. In this question, the solution is this: at the top floor, 170.37 kilonewton lateral force. Okay, for check the result, go to the display and go to the story response plot, and here is you can change auto lateral load of the structure. Here is the graph of this is the first floor, second floor, third floor. At third floor, if you check in the graph, is around 150 point something, 160 something, but in the problem here you can just see 170. Okay, let's check the data in Excel, then verify, format it. Okay, the result is verify. You can see here, this is the manually result, top floor at 170.37, or here approximately 99% is correct. And the second floor is 81.38, here 81.413, and 20.41 and this 20.35. Now the result is match. So this is the correct way of seismic analysis in E-tabs of three-story building. If you want to learn manually, then comment. If you want dynamic analysis and other software, and comment. And if you want to learn E-tab in detail from basic to advanced, you can comment. And very thank you for support my work, become a Patreon. $3 is minimum. If you like my work, you can pay more because I required. Okay, so this is the step. You can check the start animation for animated video of frame under the dead load. You can check also bending moment and shear force from here. Here. And as many more things in E-tab, you can generate in very fast report as a project report, and very more things in E-tabs. Is a very big software, very advanced software, is very important for job, BTech, MTech and PhD. If you want to learn, please share my video, share my Patreon, because we require support my work. Please thank you. If you like this video, you can download this tutorial video from the attachment file and hand notes, handwritten notes from the attachment. Thank you very much. And the first Patreon is Naeem, that who pay me $3. Thank you very much, Naeem. And thank you to all who watch this video.